Hey guys, this is Chase Harrison, CEO of Alta Labs. Today I'm going to walk you through some basic best practices of how to create and deploy VLANs with Alta Labs. Generally, VLANs should be used if your project calls for multiple networks, often referred to as subnets. Assigning each network its own VLAN allows you to then tag the corresponding traffic so that client devices connect to the appropriate network and corresponding IP range. You can use these different networks to isolate different corporate teams like accounting, sales, operations, and even voice traffic. Or if you're introducing audio-video distribution into your network and you want to keep it isolated and prioritized, VLANs would also allow you to do that. These steps are going to assume you are using the Alta Labs Route 10. If you are not using Route 10, you will need to recreate the VLAN policy shown here in whatever router you are deploying in your project. We have already gone ahead and set up a Route 10, a network switch, and an AP6 Pro for this example. You can see they are connected and passing traffic. For this example, I'm going to create a VLAN 200 for my accounting team, VLAN 300 for my sales team, and a VLAN 400 for my operations team. To do this, I'm going to click the Route 10 icon. On the card that appears, you can see the VLAN options. By default, all untagged traffic is assigned to VLAN 1, which is also created by default. To add additional VLANs, I'm going to click the plus button. Since this is for our accounting team, I'm going to enter a value of 200 in my VLAN field, add the note accounting team, and give it a unique IP range that is different from the default network value. The pool size can be as small or as large as you want. I'm going to give it a /24 block, which will give you 253 usable IP addresses. If needed, reserve the first 10 IPs in the dynamic range for statically assigned devices. I will enter the value of 10 here. If you want to adjust the lease time, DNS values, or domain other than default, you can make those changes here. Generally, if you don't know what these values mean or do, I would suggest leaving the default values. If your network needs to enable IPv6, enable that here. Otherwise, leave it disabled. Finally, if your project calls for IGMP snooping, typically used when you are doing a lot of multicasting, media distribution, or IPTV, you'll want to enable that here. Otherwise, you can leave it disabled. I am then going to repeat those steps for each VLAN, being sure to create a new non-overlapping IP range for each subnet. Once all of my VLANs and associated subnets have been created, I'm going to open up my switch configuration card to assign certain switch ports to certain VLANs. My first two ports will be for my access points. I want my access points to support all VLANs, so I will leave those set to default for now, which allows all VLANs to pass. We will come back to how to segment the wireless client devices into their own VLANs in a moment. Ports 3 through 12 will be for accounting, 13 through 20 will be for sales, and 21 through 24 will be for operations. I can click in individual ports to change their native VLAN and restrict the allowed VLANs to individual departments corresponding to that VLAN. Or, as a faster alternative, when you need to assign multiple ports to the same VLAN policy, you can select a color from the colors group dropdown, other than black, and click Edit. Add the VLAN and restrict the appropriate VLANs in the policy you are creating. Then click Save. From the Switch Settings card, click the Select button, and now you can select all the port numbers you want associated with that new color, then click Save. You'll notice the black color changes to your newly assigned color for easy identification. Repeat the steps for each port group. Finally, since we will want all departments to be able to connect to the Wi-Fi in the building, no matter where they are located physically, we are going to use AltaPass to dynamically assign each user group a VLAN based on the password they enter to join the network. Click the Settings tab, then the Wi-Fi option. Click Add SSID, enter a broadcast name, and then add three passwords, one for each user group. The first password will be for accounting with VLAN 200. Click the dropdown, Add VLAN 200, and any rate limiting your project that may require, then repeat that for each group. Click Save. Now, as long as each team uses the correct password, they will be assigned to the correct subnet. You can verify devices are connecting to the correct subnet by clicking on the Devices tab in the Management Platform. In the Options dropdown, make sure your IP address and VLANs are checked. Then, as devices are connected to your network, you can verify they are being tagged with the appropriate VLAN and assigned the correct subnet. This is obviously only one example of how VLANs can be configured and deployed. If you have any follow-up questions, please come and engage with us in our community forum by visiting forum.alta.inc. Thank you.